Well, greetings from Adyar, where I would be putting it mildly if I were to say that the weather is warm. It is definitely warm here, but really quite wonderful. A bunch of things I want to bring you up to speed on. A number of things happened during the course of this last month. Number of them in the U.S., and then also things abroad at Adyar. I'm going to take you this time out to Krotona, and then also bring you inside of one of our meetings that was held for our webinar program. Just thought it would be interesting for you to see how that sort of thing is working. Quite the high-tech event that takes place with our meetings from time to time. This one was a meeting of, I think, 9 different people who were brought together from 3 different locations around the country. This one was just in the United States. So I'll give you a chance to see some of that. Out of Krotona was a beautiful meeting that was held. I actually had a chance to spend some time with the national president from the section there in Australia, Linda Oliveira, and her husband Pedro. Also, it's always good to get out there and to see some of the folks who are doing the work out at Krotona. Very special place that's really holding down an important part of the work of the TS in the United States, also in the world. Back at Adyar, we had some bad news in the sense that the beautiful structure that had been erected for the convention, the Adyar theater roof, collapsed. There was a rain and the structure actually collapsed, brought down a couple of the poles. Fortunately, it happened during the evening, so the late night hours actually. So no body was involved, no person or animal was injured, but quite a disappointment in terms of the lifespan. It just was put up for the December convention, and it was never completely finished. But these are things that are being examined. We will have another structure back. We will learn from this particular mistake, but it is something that is it's a disappointment. But like with other disappointments, you find out what's to it and move on. If we can be in the pattern of Blavatsky and Besant and others who made countless mistakes, you make a mistake and hopefully you can learn and then you take it to the next step and improve on what you did before. So that's what we're going to be doing here. Already it's being examined and we'll have specific answers as we go along. All right, so with that, probably it's time just to start our little tour, so I hope you enjoy it. Well, the spring has fully arrived at Olcott with all of the beautiful flowers that are typical to the area coming out in full force. Well, it's a beautiful time to be there. Also, every spring, the Book Expo of America took place this year in Chicago at McCormick Place. Had a chance to meet with our book distributor, Red Wheel Weiser, headed by Michael Kerber, and talk about some ideas for the future with Quest Publications. We had a meeting of our online program committee, and it was conducted. It's relating to our webinars, our online programming. Jim Bosco, who has actually been the heart and soul of this program, put it all together and linked us across the country. Cy Ginsberg coming in from Florida, Gwen Mayer coming in from Texas, in a meeting to plan for the future of our programs. So here's just a slice
she
of it.
She also hosts meetings when I can't, and she's being trained to do hosting on her own so that I can have someone else who can cover some of the meetings, which is important right now.
So what are you coming up to Wheaton, Gwen?
Yeah, I'm coming to stay there for a couple of days to train with Jim.
From Olcott, it was on to California and one of the stranger rainbows I have witnessed, of course, in Los Angeles, and then to Krotona, the Krotona Institute of Theosophy in Ojai, California, where the first thing that greeted my sight upon coming up the hill was these deer roving outside of the Krotona Library. It's a beautiful natural area, and they've planted a number of different fruit-bearing trees. These are loquats. And so my breakfast on many mornings looked a lot like this: tangerines, kumquats, loquats. It's a great group of people who had gathered for the meeting. Robert Elwood, Linda Oliveira, and her husband Pedro, they had come in from Australia. The meeting took place at the time of the Wesak full moon, so there was an evening of sitting and meditation on the library patio. Probably many of you who have ever been to Krotona know that it's a 118-acre estate on top of a hill there, right in just outside of the downtown of Ojai, which developed around it. In 1912, Krotona was in Hollywood until the movie industry expanded so much that they had to move. So in 1924, the property in Hollywood, the Krotona Colony, was sold. And then the proceeds were divided between the American section and the esoteric school. And these properties, the properties for the United States, for the American section, were purchased in the Olcott headquarters. And then these ones were purchased for the Krotona place. Beautiful place, ringed by mountains. Has been there since 1924 and has witnessed the whole area grow up around it. But a jewel in the Theosophical Society's crown. So from the US, then it was on to Adyar by way of Frankfurt, Germany, where we always have a layover in our flights. Beautiful airport, also because it's such a large airport, you get a chance to get a little bit of exercise between flights, because it's at least a mile and a half of walking to get between the gates from which you travel. At Adyar, went in time for the continuing cleanup of the Adyar River that has been taking place. So much garbage, tons of it have been deposited along the banks of the river. And a huge cleanup campaign of thousands of people has been taking place, and we've been a part of that. And they focused on our grounds each week, each Friday they've been there. Anand Aryan has been instrumental in organizing all of these things, and they bring out tons of trash each time. Some of the fellows from our own maintenance crew were a part of it and helped to get this enormous pile, just one of the piles, that was established on the grounds. There's a lot of wildlife on the grounds. This jackal, which is very similar to a fox, was very, very sick, and it was my wife and some others came upon it. It wasn't even moving and the dogs were about to attack it. So we kept it overnight, had a chance for our vet with the Besant Memorial Animal Dispensary to take a look, and the next day we were able to release it back into the wild. So it was a fascinating glimpse of wildlife right in the middle of a city of 7 million people.
Yeah.
So my first week was a blur of meetings with, here's the treasurer, Narasimha Rao, and his supporting crew. Got a chance to meet with them in their treasury office. Also the Dream Runners Association. More than 4,000 people participate in a race that begins at our own Olcott School. Also the damage that occurred with our Adyar Theater roof. Have been assessing that beautiful structure that was erected in time for our convention, but had some flaws that resulted in an actual collapse of the roof during the recent heavy rains. So we're having the report done on what exactly led to that particular failure. Countless structures in the area of this same type, but obviously there was some problem in ours. So we'll be able to work on that and put up a better top the next time. At the Adyar Library and Research Center, the digitization process that has been going on, this with the palm leaf manuscripts, as well as the other handwritten manuscripts that we have, also have been doing digitization work in moving the card catalog into a digital format. So here you see some of the palm leaves. We have 18,000 palm leaf manuscripts. Each one of these is two-sided and is being photographed for digital use. Handwritten manuscripts we're doing largely through scanning process. All of these things are being put on into digital format to be able to be used around the world. Swamiji has been instrumental in putting this process together. The Adyar Archives, just a couple little things I wanted to show you, very fascinating. HPB's scrapbooks, there are 32 of them, which we have started to digitize, and we'll have that done before the year is out. A lot of it is just newspaper articles that HBB found interesting, but some of the other ones are drawings that were in newspapers that she elaborated upon. So in this particular one, someone is in front of a firing squad of American Indians. It's the cavalry. And you have Judaism, Spiritism, Spiritualism, all taking aim at the theosophical Achilles. Fascinating.